Comes back to gentrification in many ways. What is the purpose? Yes, they do increase mobility, but then there is a certain kind of another kind of exclusion that they are perpetrating in terms of classism, in terms of who can be there, who can access that space. So I'm a bit conflicted about the newer ones that have popped up. I feel like we need to get across those delineations in some ways and blurring them, which is why I like this initiative and can get behind it more.
Like even when you go to one of these high-end dhabas, right, wahan pe kind of boundary bani bhi hogi. You'd never see one of those at these dhabas, which are all called Quetta Hotel for some reason. So, and you'd see a guard there. So, you know, there's a sort of policing and surveillance aspect, which I do not associate with a true public space because it instantly like has a wall. So we're not sure if we can get behind that.
Yeah.
Also, like, whenever I also go to these high-end dhabas, I'm always told you can sit in the family section.
Yeah.
Like, why? As in, I, as a single woman, or even if I'm with my friends, why do I have to be policed into this family section to make it respectable? Like Natasha said, like, it's this whole, that it looks better if a woman is sitting in a cordoned-off area, which, again, as Sadia said, is not the concept of a public space.
Yeah, that's a good question. It's about membership and how do we go about it across class in many ways. You know, we don't... So far, we haven't. What we've really tried to keep in mind is making this a community-oriented effort. So our approach is to start organically with our own communities and then build those solidarities over time so that they are more genuine and more inclusive. I can go to a lower-income class area tomorrow and try to recruit women there, but it won't feel genuine. It won't be organic. I won't be getting them on board at their pace. So. I think a community-oriented approach is a key in terms of going about this organically.
Yeah, whether some of the other members have been abroad or not, our experiences as women are so central to our communal building efforts that we all end up relating to each other anyway.
I think something that people are like, oh, girls at dhabas movement and... thodi sensationalization ho jati hai foreign media se especially. So we're like being very wary of international media requests these days and not really giving in, because no matter what they say, they always end up like fucking it up, right? And we don't think of ourselves as a movement. Like, there are movements in Pakistan. There is a gender movement. It's been going on for decades, way long before there was any girl at any dhaba, and there have been girls at dhabas before us. But what this is more, we see it as like a way to
Start a discourse
and share experiences and use experience sharing as the grounds for, some sort of change. ripple effect. So when you're talking about experience sharing as your main tool, then the pace is going to be very slow. So we're not looking for some kind of overnight fixing of Karachi and Lahore streets. I don't think that's going to happen in our lifetimes even. But because there is so much within feminism, we feel like this is an important aspect of it that needs a space to be talked about. And it wasn't something we sat down and decided, okay, oh, let's talk about this, right? It organically happened, which convinces us that it needs to be talked about because it surfaced.
And also, public space is the lowest common denominator. Within feminism, I think it's one of the few issues that
within feminism, for sure.
That if within feminism, I think it's one of the few issues that affects all women. Beyond just a domestic violence, you have a certain percentage and all of that. Public space is something every woman in Pakistan would probably think about her relationship with at one point or the other. So, us tarah se, I think it's a good issue to bring everyone on board, potentially. Jaise chai is also the lowest common denominator. Ye sara ka dialogue tha, which I
hamari dost.
So, ye hai baat. Bollywood.
Bollywood,
I think, influences Pakistan as much as India, I guess. Jitna log yahan pe bhi kafi craze hai aur log dekhte hain aur inspire hote hain. To jo wahan pe uska potential hai, wo yahan pe bhi hai potentially, I guess. Thoda zyada slow hoga, but
It's the same. It's all the same hypocrisies of like entertainment, uh-huh. Right? Where everyone will rush. All men will be like my own father will watch item songs at home, right? And it's like. But he'll police what I wear, and if I'm showing like even this attire that I have on right now, sleeveless, is unacceptable to him at home. So wo dekhenge sari filme aur, but then think about how Bollywood depicts family values, how it depicts what ambition for women look like, and even within Pakistani media there has been, although like Urdu shows ki apni ek hai history jo ki India se hi aa rahi hai, but we've also internalized a lot of the soap opera ke jo values hote hain jo TV pe aap log dekhte honge. Similarly with ads, although lately I think the ad industry, and even I don't know within Bollywood, but you know, fringe groups like All India Bakchod or Girly Apa, like all of these
and
new groups
and these new,
yeah,
Girly Apa,
Ladies Room,
that's an amazing web series.
Amazing.
So those kind of things we don't really see happening here, so it gives us some like sort of, you know, I think we draw fuel from that, like seeing, okay, across the border the conversation has, within limited circles, yes, but it's happening, it's progress. People can at least question slut shaming, right? Yahan pe you can't even bring that up because sex is so taboo. So talking about sex is automatically like, it's not a layer we've been able to openly discuss through our initiative. So those limitations are more, I think, intense. And it gives us inspiration to see some cutting edge work coming from India. People who are trying to challenge these narratives. Women who are doing this, and you know, we think, okay, वहाँ हो सकता था तो यहाँ भी eventually हो जाएगा, एक ही जड़ से आ रहे हैं ना. Next question. How do your immediate families feel about the initiative? Are they supportive? We'll take turns.
Okay.
You start. You're the best with the family situation.
Okay. So my father is our biggest supporter, but he loves it. He reads everything that the page posts, and then he will ask, is this Sadia? Is this Natasha? Like, he will know. He knows all the names. And even even if at home I'd say I'm going to meet at a dhaba, they'll say, oh, is it a girls at dhaba's meeting? And I think even Sadia can tell you, she met my father on a flight, and she was like, oh my god.
I'm sitting on a flight, and there's this old gentleman sitting next to me, and he's reading a book, I slept throughout the flight. When we were getting up to leave, we landed in Karachi. We start talking, just like, you know, what do you do? And so I'm telling him, and usually older people don't know about girls at dhabas, right?
Yeah.
So it's a shock for me when they do, especially a man. So he's like, what do you do? I'm like, oh, you know, I'm a writer, this, and I also do this other like women thing. He's like, oh, what do you do? I'm like, have you heard of girls at dhabas? You probably have. He's like, yes, of course I have. Do you know Atya? And I'm like, that's so, yes? Like, oh, she's my daughter. I'm like, oh my god. So her father is really great. Unlike mine, who he doesn't know much about it. He knows that we're trying to gather funds to open a dhaba. He thinks it's a terrible idea, that I am whacked and I'm ruining my life and I should be doing some kind of a, you know, settled job. I don't know if he's ever seen the page. I've never talked to him about it, but I know he has an idea that she does go to dhabas a lot. But what is Girls at Dhabas? What does it do? The fact that I've put myself out there is not something he's as familiar with. My mother wasn't familiar with it initially, but she's very technology savvy, so wo Facebook pe pahunch gayi aur unne dekh liya Girls at Dhabas, and then she was freaking out a lot because, you know, pictures of me in public with boys, pictures of me with cigarettes, I'm writing about really intimate experiences in public space and otherwise from my life. So a lot of the, we also publish a lot of, like, sort of, we call it Dhaba Journal or just chai stories, or, you know, just like everyday stories and experiences of chai community and public spaces. So she would read that, and then she'd like, I'd get a call and be like, she'd be like, ye wali line se ye wala loves nikalo, or what if, or she'd be like, you know, maine aaj tak page like nahi kiya hua kyunki agar main like karungi to mere doston ke timeline pe aa jayega aur family ko pata chal jayega. So it's tough. Her main thing is like, why do you have to do it? I understand that mobility is an issue for women, and I understand that things are not easy in our country and they will be slow and they'll take a time to change, but why do you have to be one of the women who is like owning the fact that mujhe is pe kaam karna hai, right? Even if it means just telling my stories. But she's warmed up to it a bit. Yeah, Natasha?
Yeah, I've also heard the why do you have to do it part from my mom. But she's been, I think change aaya hai thoda over time. He pehle shuru mein mujhe khud jab uncomfortable feel hota tha dhabe pe baithna, wo bhi koi, I hope Urdu mein baat karna sahi hai na?
Haan, Urdu mein baat karna sahi hai?
Okay. So ye tha ki initially it was harder to explain, but over time as she's seen the conversation we've been having, and then I've tried to include her as well, ki how this is connected to what we've faced over time at home. In terms of how patriarchy has shaped her experiences, then I think she finds a more she relates with it more now and is more accepting and understanding of it. But it's taken time.
So the first question is, what did I mean by furthering the same?
Not furthering the same thing
that we're battling. So I believe I said that in the context of intersectionality, right? So for actually these questions are linked. Her second question is that, how do we define public space? Is it a nuanced definition? Wohi malls wali baat,
okay,
yeah?
Okay, so
furthering, not furthering the same thing we're battling. So if we're saying that, you know, public spaces should be more accessible and should be seen with the narrative of access rather than fear or exclusion, then we have to understand how it's, like, we're not just talking about gender here, we're also talking about money.
And class,
right? Because gender is just one of the many identities on the basis of which somebody is excluded from public space. Which is why something like malls or coffee shops or the high-end dhabas that we were talking about earlier, they do not constitute as public space, because you have a barrier you have to get through, a guard there, a certain capital you need, you have to be a certain kind of consumer, you need money power
to
be able to, you need to look a certain way. There are places in Karachi that will not let you enter because you are wearing chappals.
Or because you came on a bike,
right? So that kind of exclusion is not different from the exclusion that's based on gender, because both are exclusions that are based upon somebody's identity or perceived identity, right? So if we are saying that we want public spaces to be inclusive of all genders, we also, that battle goes hand in hand with being inclusive to all
identities,
whether we're talking about sexual identity or class identity. And we're not saying ke ek dam se we can achieve all of this and we can, you know, but that's the sort of goal, that's where you want to get to. And if that's where you want to get to, then our kind of fight
our
kind of storytelling
or struggle.
Our struggles cannot be rooted in the private public spaces that you're talking about, for example high-end dhabas, because we could have been, you know, we could be having these conversations and bringing people, taking girls with us to these high-end dhabas where they'd feel safer and more comfortable, but then we are perpetuating the same system which is of exclusion that we are saying we want to battle.
And also,
does that explain what you were getting at? Yeah? Okay. Atiya will add more.
Okay.
My point was also, like, as Natasha said, if we go to high-end dhabas or public private spaces, it's all again perpetuating the idea that you need to be safe and protected, which is not the main thing. I think one thing that I've learned through them is, like, how certain, like the fruit seller and all of these men are kind of villainized, and they are seen as a threat when they actually, Sadia can tell you, these interactions are not that threatening. It's not threatening to be out in public space. And as violence, as they said, violence occurs more in private spaces.
I mean, physical, yeah.
So physical. Like, and so then the idea that you need to be safe and protected is also again patriarchal.
How do the Dhaba staff and owners react to you and your initiative?
Okay. I mean, so far.
We also don't like make a fanfare, you know. Yeah, we don't like come with a hi, we are the girls and we are
here to take over your dhaba, huh?
Yeah, like right now we're a bit of a scene because there are these, like, there's all this gear here,
there's,
and there's a laptop
and
there's
mics and
this is an odd side, so you know, it's kind of like us declaring, like, look, we are here, but that's usually not the kind of energy we believe in going into public space for, like, yeah, sometimes when there's a lot of us, in the end of it, we'll sit down together and pose and take a picture. But, you know, the idea isn't that, oh, you put on a show. The idea is that you interact with the space and you
normalize
your own experience, and you kind of lessen your own fear a little bit each time. It is true that I get catcalled on public. I'm not saying that it's safe for me to be, like, it's, there is no harassment women feel.
No, there
but,
is harassment.
But the point is that harassment I am facing through, on the street, I am facing online, I am facing in the circles of friends that I have, but in a different form. So that is there regardless.
It's not an exceptional
harassment. It's not an exceptional harassment. It's like, it's street, and the way to, like, it'll only change if the landscape changes, right?
Yeah.
But even then, if there are, let's say, two incidents of someone catcalling, then there'll be eight where, you know, okay, they looked and then they looked away. The second time you pass by, they look away. Third time you pass by, they won't look. By now it's normal. As for dhabas, I think because of the space that it is, where, you know, people aren't really there for pundi. How do you translate that? Do you guys know what pundi is? it's a term used to
check out girls.
Like, you know, a bunch of, imagine a bunch of guys just like sitting near the sea in Mumbai, I guess, because we have sea view pe bahut hota hai yahan pe, and they're just like there to just check out girls, you know. So it's called doing pundi. You just gather with the intention that
no, and also like friendships, right? I mean,
friendships, yeah.
With dhaba owners, with people who work there.
The assumption,
Especially when you've been to a dhaba more than like a few times, and it's become a place where you frequent, then there are relationships to be made there with the people around you, and that's also a new. Another barrier being broken.
One man had come up to me basically at a dhaba and asked for my number. A random man, not someone at the dhaba. Someone in a car got off, came up to me asking for my number. So I like shoot him away. And then afterward, the dhaba wala came up to me and sat down. And we had this amazing conversation. And I realized that, you know, this is like, is this what we're scared of? Matlab,
nahi, aur violator mein bhi likha hua hai ke the fear is not that you will get harassed outside on the street. The fear is that you'll develop sexual relationships with people across, different from your class, you know. So that is at the core of even feminism. I think Nigahat Khan, who has been actually a fierce critic of ours, but also said the same thing, ke, you know, Pakistan would have like achieved more plurality when an upper class woman starts can marry a lower class man, you know. So ye khud unhone kaha tha, to usi ko baat ko leke, this could be one step in that direction, I don't know, yeah.
There's the our dhaba friend. Hello. Salam.
This is Fair Hall. Wahan baith ke hum kya baat kar rahe the is din? Kyun thi ye meeting?
I think so. Was this for Kandeen?
No, it was just a feminist collective
meeting. The feminist collective popped up recently as well as a response to address sexism within leftist activist circles. So to talk about women's experiences within activism and how sometimes there's harassment there too, you know? Mm-hmm. In spaces you wouldn't think there would be.
That is my mother. This is the only, it took 2 years to get her to come with me to a dhaba and to convince her to take a photo. So this is like a personal victory. This is the pilot dhaba. This is the first time we set up a dhaba at a festival. We did it like a. So this is what our dhaba looks like. It's not very elaborate.
And we made people wash their own cups.
Oh yeah, yeah. We made people wash their
this
own
was
cups.
The best.
Which is the Bharatis over there.
The men were trying to get out of it, and we're trying to get the women to do it. We had like people stationed there, not as a police, but just like gentle reminder that you have your cup.
Dho ke wapas den taki aur chai bane.
And this was very tested. Okay, can we do this? Can we make chai for people who keep coming and going? And so it was at a festival.
And this was a super elite space. Okay? You know, like this is called Beach Luxury Hotel. उन्होंने हमें कहा कि आप आके यहाँ पे ढाबा खोले. मुझे उसकी समझ में नहीं आई थोड़ी बात कि कैसे होगा, इसका मकसद क्या होगा. What is this going to achieve? फिर हमने सोचा कि maybe to make this a bit more self-reflective and introspective, we should ask people to wash their own cups and experience self-reliance maybe for a bit.
But I think about this corner, it was really interesting because I was stationed and telling people to wash their cups. It was literally sisters who are recording their brothers who said that, oh my god, he's never done that.
Main kal protest mein gayi thi.
Oh, talk about that. Yeah.
To protest against the murder of this kid in college, which is, I think, a very public space issue as well, who was lynched and murdered in a very horrific way because he was accused of blasphemy. But it was a beautiful protest. We recited a lot of poetry. Beyond Press Club, we went around other parts of the city. Walked around together. Narebazi bahut zor se ki. Maza aaya.
Oh, it was amazing. And I had tears in my eyes, believe me. It was... I think I'm proud of my friends here for doing this. And you guys are awesome.
I thought it was amazing. It was one of the best talks that we've ever had here.
This is one of the most amazing talks that I've ever come to in Creative Mornings, probably because of the content and the kind of experiences that these guys have gone through. And they're really putting in a really good effort there, and we're so happy to see what they're doing in Pakistan. And I see a lot of connect between there and here. So glad to see all the beautiful pictures too, and cheers to you guys. You guys are doing something really nice.
It was extremely delightful, I think, and it was good to see the perspective from, you know, because to be honest, for me, the interesting part about it was that I was experiencing Pakistan to some extent, okay, really up close. I you know, did not imagine it to be like that, and you know, to be honest, I think that's the first thing, that kind of veil that went up from my eyes, and I was like really surprised that it is no different from the way we are, right? And I think we need to have more dialogue.